Hi, my name is Sarah Zambor, and I'm a BCBA at Brett DiNovi & Associates. Today, I'm going to be discussing applied behavior analysis, also known as ABA, and health coaching. This video covers C1, C9, E2, E3, E4, and E6 on the 5th edition BACB task list. In their 2020 article titled Health Coaching by Behavior Analysts in Practice, How and Why, Norman and Bober note the urgency to address many health problems that currently exist in the United States. In 2018, Fire and colleagues noted that approximately 40% of adults and 18.5% of children and adolescents in the United States are clinically obese, and that obesity rates have nearly doubled since the 1980s. These statistics come with an increased number of young adults diagnosed with type 2 diabetes and an increase in the type of cancers that are most commonly associated with diabetes. The increased obesity rates, in addition to the rise of other health issues, comes with an increase in healthcare costs. The current costs related to obesity in the United States are estimated at $175 billion and are steadily increasing. While weight gain and obesity can sometimes be a common side effect of some medications or a genetic predisposition, in general, as a society, we are eating entirely too much and exercising entirely too little. According to the U.S. Department of Health and Human Services, the average American diet contains too much salt, calories from fat, saturated fats, added sugars, and refined grains. The U.S. Department of Health and Human Services also notes approximately 78% of adults do not follow the recommended guidelines, which include engaging in at least 150 to 300 minutes of moderate physical activity or 75 to 150 minutes of vigorous activity per week. While our society is spending large amounts of time and money attempting to recover from health complications, we are failing to take the necessary steps to prevent health problems from occurring in the first place. This is especially alarming as the U.S. Department of Health and Human Services notes approximately half of the U.S. population is living with a chronic disease that could be prevented or at least minimized by making lifestyle changes. We have the ability to become healthier without relying on a variety of pills or specialist visits, yet our health is actually getting worse. The health problems the United States is currently facing are certainly socially significant and can and should be addressed through the science of applied behavior analysis. However, it is imperative behavior analysts recognize and stay within their scope of competence when addressing any health-related issues. In 2014, Covey and colleagues reviewed 13 studies from 2009 through 2013 that analyzed the impact of health coaching on improving health outcomes and found that participants showed an improvement in weight management, increased physical activity levels, and improved mental and physical health. In 2011, Simmons and Wolever also found health coaching led to improvements in cardiovascular health, pain management for cancer patients, diabetes management, and improved outcomes in individuals with a body mass index, or BMI, over 30. While the results just mentioned are encouraging, the Norman and Bober 2020 article mentioned earlier, the authors note that most published evaluations regarding health coaching include varying coaching practices, employ non-randomized group designs, report high rates of participant attrition, and do not involve direct measures on health behavior. While these limitations make for less than ideal results, they can be addressed by applying the principles of applied behavior analysis to the field of health coaching. Another limitation of health coaching is the inconsistent definition regarding what exactly health coaching entails. While definitions vary among resources, most definitions include common elements and place a focus on helping clients determine what is important to them and include a focus on collaboration between the coach and client. The health coach and client work together to set goals that are meaningful to the client, and the coach provides resources and support throughout the client's journey. In behavior analytic terms, health coaches provide task clarification, help individuals set small, obtainable goals, provide feedback, teach individuals to self-monitor, and arranges antecedents and consequences to evoke or reinforce behavior change. The principles of applied behavior analysis can also be utilized in health coaching by helping the client create operational definitions of the behavior they want to change, helping the client set SMART goals, meaning goals that are specific, measurable, attainable, relevant, and time-bound, collecting baseline data regarding the client's current behavior, and monitoring data on a consistent basis to ensure strategies recommended are effective, helping to determine the function of the client's behavior, helping to determine appropriate replacement behaviors the client can engage in, and helping to determine ways in which the client's replacement behavior will come in contact with reinforcement that occurs naturally in the client's environment. In 2017, Finn and Watson noted it may be valuable to consider the conceptual basis for functional relationships in the client's environment. Finn and Watson noted health behaviors are operant behaviors, and individuals engage in daily habits operating their environment for better health choices and improved long-term outcomes. Behavior analysts can look at health coaching using the four-term contingency, including motivation, antecedent, behavior, and consequence. This can be useful to guide clients through their own behavior and understanding its relationship on the environment. To be a successful health coach, it is important behavior analysts learn the basic concepts and principles of diet, exercise, and fitness, and familiarize themselves with health coaching strategies and evidence supporting them. Credentials are available for several professions related to health coaching. However, at this time, the American Council on Exercise is the only organization accredited by the National Commission for Certifying Agencies, which is the same body that accredits the BACB. Norman and Bober note the skills of a health coach overlap with those of a BCBA, and that both the American Council on Exercise and BACB describe performance domains and specific tasks relevant to their respective practices. The American Council on Exercise divides their various performance domains into task statements, which are further categorized into knowledge and skill statements. And the BACB provides a task list that is organized into foundations or underlying principles and applications or more practice-oriented skills. For behavior analysts interested in health coaching, understanding their scope of practice and relying on evidence-based procedures is important. However, it is also equally important for behavior analysts to be wary of strategies being promoted that are not evidence-based. While it is likely that behavior analysts practicing at health coaches may come in contact with strategies that are not empirically supported, Norman and Bober note these situations are really no different than what behavior analysts may encounter when attending an IEP meeting with an interdisciplinary team. When such situations arise in which it is suggested that the behavior analyst use a procedure that is not evidence-based, it is the responsibility of the behavior analyst to refrain from using the recommendation. However, it is important to note this can be done by respecting another professional's opinion and working as part of a team. While the principles of applied behavior analysis are starting to become more widely used outside the autism spectrum population, including areas such as organizational and behavior management, applied animal behavior, and mental health, there are few behavior analysts exploring the health coaching route. This is likely due to the fact that most health coaches start part-time and slowly build their client base, which can be difficult for an individual who is looking for full-time employment. Behavior analysts interested in practicing as health coaches will most likely have to start their own agency, which can be a daunting task. While breaking into the field of health coaching can be challenging, it can also help pave the way for other behavior analysts interested in the health coaching niche. Behavior analysts have the ability to help make the world a healthier place and make contributions to the development of practice in a relatively new field. And as Skinner noted, virtually all the problems facing modern society are problems of human behavior. To solve these problems, we need to foster a natural science of behavior and broadly disseminate the application derived from that science.